I am Lakshmi Prasanna, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. In this session, we will learn how to interface memory and I/O devices to 8051 microcontroller. So, before learning how to interface memory and I/O devices to 8051 microcontroller, first we need to see what are the features of 8051 microcontroller. So here, this 8051 microcontroller is called an 8-bit microcontroller. Why? Because the data bus size of 8051 microcontroller is only 8-bit. So it is capable of performing 8-bit operations. So it means the size of ALU and the size of flag register, that is PSW, the sizes will be only 8-bit. And so next feature is here, it consists of 16-bit address bus. So the number of address lines that is available in this 8051 microcontroller is 16. So here the number of data lines will be only 8. So it will be from D0 to D7. So whereas the number of address lines are 16. So it will be from A0 to A15. Okay. And so it is able to generate a 16-bit address only, and it consists of 4 register banks. Here the 4 register banks are bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 and bank 3. So these are the 4 register banks. Each register bank consists of 8 registers. So 8 registers will be from R0 to R7. So each register is having its fixed address in the address space. And so it consists of 32 general purpose registers, and each register size is of 8-bit. And so 16-bit program counter it is having, and the data pointer register also is of 16-bit. So the program counter register size will be 16-bit. Why? Because the program counter is a register which is used to store the address of the next instruction that is going to be fetched. So here, since it is holding the address of the next instruction address, so here the address bus size is 16-bit. So to hold the address, the program counter register size should also be of 16-bit. And the data pointer register is a 16-bit register. We can use it as 2 8-bit registers as DPL and DPH. So here DPL represents the lower order 8 bits and DPH represents the higher order 8 bits. And so next it consists of 4 kilobytes of on-chip program memory. So program memory can also be called as ROM. Why? Because the entire code what we are writing in the assembly level language program, that entire code will be present in this ROM, stored in this ROM. So that is why it is called program memory. And so next one is, it consists of 128 bytes of on-chip data memory. So here data memory is considered as RAM, that is random access memory. So the content other than program, other than code, the remaining data and all will be stored in this data memory only. So here this 4 kilobytes of ROM and 128 bytes of RAM, these two are the internal memories which is present inside 8051 microcontroller. And next one is, it consists of 2 timers. So here each timer is of 16-bit. So we can use here the 2 timers as timer 0 and timer 1. Timer 0 is of 16-bit. We can use that as 2 8-bit registers by considering it as TL0 and TH0. And timer 1 is also 16-bit register. We can use it as 2 8-bit registers by considering them as TH1 and TL1. And so next, it consists of 4 8-bit ports. So 8051 microcontroller is having 4 ports, that is port 1 and port 2, port 3 and port 4. So it consists of totally 4 ports. Okay. So each port size is of 8 bit and all these ports are bidirectional ports. And next one is, it consists of 3 internal and 2 external interrupts. So these are the number of interrupts that are available in 8051 microcontroller. And it also consists of 1 serial communication port, that is UART, which is called Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. And here these 3, 1 serial communication port, this serial communication port is also available inside 8051 microcontroller only. Next one is, so the registers that are available in 8051 microcontroller, they are called special function registers. In that special function register, some of the registers are bit addressable, whereas some of the registers are not bit addressable. So if you consider here, bit as well as byte addressable RAM area of 16 bytes. And next one is, it consists of 12 clock cycles to constitute 1 mission cycle. So here 1 mission cycle consists of totally 12 clock cycles. That entire 12 clock cycles can be divided into 6 states. Each state consists of 2 pulses, P1 and P2. So all these are some of the features of 8051 microcontroller. So here we have studied that on-chip memory, that is the memory present inside 8051 microcontroller, internal memory. ROM is of 4 KB and RAM is of 128 bytes. But here, what is the main advantage of this in 8051 microcontroller is, if this internal memory is not enough, there is also possibility of connecting external memory. So that is what we will learn here, interfacing memory to 8051 microcontroller. And also we will learn how much amount of external memory can be interfaced to 8051 microcontroller. That means how much amount of RAM can be interfaced and how much amount of ROM can be interfaced to 8051 microcontroller. Now, so here the 8051 microcontroller is not limited to the internal memory. So there is also possibility of connecting external memory by using I/O ports. So here the amount of internal RAM that is available is 128 bytes and the internal ROM that is available inside 8051 microcontroller is 4 kilobytes. Now, so there is also possibility of connecting external RAM and ROM, which is called data memory and program memory, if this internal memory is not sufficient. So in some cases, there will be some set of instructions which need to be executed and it takes more amount of space. So in such cases, there is a possibility of connecting this external RAM and ROM. Okay. So the reason of external program memory, which is called ROM. So for example, if there is any complex programs that are written in the high level language, will occupy more amount of memory. So if this is the case, this internal memory may not be enough. It is not sufficient. So because of that reason, we are going to use this external RAM and ROM. And another reason is, in some microcontrollers like 8031 microcontroller and 8032 microcontroller, these are the 2 microcontrollers where internal memory is not present. Okay, so these are the 2 microcontrollers which does not have internal ROM. So in this type of microcontrollers, since the internal ROM is not present, we need to interface the external ROM in order to store the program and data. And so these are the main reasons why we have to interface external ROM and RAM to 8051 microcontroller. So how much amount of external ROM and RAM can be interfaced to 8051 means, so a maximum of 64 kilobytes of ROM and that is data memory, also 64 KB, can be interfaced to 8051 microcontroller. Okay, so that means here maximum amount of ROM you can interface externally is 64 KB, and maximum amount of RAM that you can interface externally is also 64 KB. Now, so here we can see this is the general diagram to show memory interfacing to 8051 microcontroller. So here this is 8051 microcontroller. If the internal memory present inside 8051 microcontroller is not enough, so we can connect this RAM and ROM externally to 8051 microcontroller using this process. So here the maximum amount of RAM you can interface is 64 KB, and maximum amount of ROM you can interface is also 64 KB. Okay, and so here this RAM is having one OE signal and this ROM is also having one OE signal. Okay, so here this OE signal of this ROM should be connected to the PSEN bar signal of 8051 microcontroller in order to enable this ROM read only memory. So using this only the microcontroller is going to take or consider the ROM of 64 KB. And here we have P0. So here 8051 microcontroller is having four ports: port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. Okay, so port 0 consists of multiplexed address and data lines, that is from AD0 to AD7. Okay, so by using this port 0 and here by using this ALE signal and this latch, we are going to demultiplex the address and data lines. Okay, so that is why here we will get A0 to A7 address lines, and using this data lines we will get D0 to D7. So ALE means here address latch enable, it is active low signal. When that ALE bar signal is enabled and the multiplexed address and data lines will get demultiplex. And here we are also having the latch which is used to demultiplex the address and data signals. And here we have this port 2 connected to RAM, and along with that we also have two control signals, WR bar and RD bar. So that is write signal and read signal. Okay, so this is how we have to interface 64 KB of RAM and 64 KB of ROM externally to 8051 microcontroller. And for this ROM also we can see here this is address lines A0 to A7, and this is the remaining address lines A8 to A15. So here these address lines are coming after latch. Why? Because previously from A0 to A7, the number of address lines whatever we have, they are multiplexed with the data lines. So to demultiplex them, you have to take after the latch. So this is how we have to interface memory externally to 8051 microcontroller. And so here in order to interface external ROM to 8051 microcontroller, so this is the procedure we have to follow. So here we can see there is a ROM, read only memory, so which is also called as program memory. So the main program will be stored in this ROM only. And here we have 8051 microcontroller which consists of four ports, that is P0, P1, P2 and P3. So here P1 is called dedicated port. Why? Because it is used only for connecting IO devices, that means it is used only as IO ports. Whereas here port 3, if we consider each port, they act as IO lines. as well as each port is having its own operation like read, write, transmit data, receive data, two interrupt signals, two signals related to timers. Okay, each signal will be having its own operation in port 3. Whereas here, if you consider port 0, it consists of, it acts as IO ports as well as multiplexed address data lines. And here, if you see this port 2, it acts as data lines and also IO ports. That is why here, since this P0 is having multiplexed address and data lines, using port 0 only, we need to demultiplex this address and data lines. So address and data lines, that is AD0 to AD7, we have multiplexed address and data lines. Whereas the remaining address lines from A8 to A15, they are simple, normal address lines. Okay. So because the size of the data bus is 8 bit and the size of the address bus is 16 bit. So that is why using this P0 and with the help of this ALE signal, address latch enable, we have to demultiplex the address and data multiplex lines. So because of that only we have used here latch. And here we are using this port 2 in order to have another address lines. So these are the address lines that are connected to port 2. So the operation of port 2 pins are, they act as simple IO pins and they can also be acting as the address lines also, that is higher order address lines. So this, using this port 2 only, we have to connect the higher order address lines from A8 to A15. And another one we have to see here is the PSEN bar signal should be connected to the OE bar signal of this ROM. Okay. So here port 0 is having simple IO ports and it also consists of multiplex address and data lines. And so it is having 8-bit address that is latched by using ALE signal. And port 2 will handle higher order address lines, that is from A8 to A15. It is 8-bit higher order address bus. And in order to interface, the PSEN bar signal should be connected to the OE bar signal of ROM. So here OE indicates output enable. So using that signal only the external ROM can be connected. So this is the way we have to interface whatever the size of ROM we are going to consider. Now, so here we have taken an example. So let us see how to interface this external ROM to 8051 microcontroller. So design a microcontroller system by using 8051. So interface external ROM which is of size 4K by 8. So following this 4K by 8 size ROM, following the previous procedure, what we have seen how to interface, we have to draw the interfacing diagram here. Next, so what is the size of the memory that is given? The memory size is 4K here. Okay, so now we have to write that 4K in terms of 2 power n, where here n represents the number of address lines. So as we know here, the value of 2 power 10 is 1K and 2 power 11 is 2K, 2 power 12 is 4K. So similarly, we can write here 2 power 13 as 8K, 2 power 14 as 16K, so 2 power 15 as 32K. So similarly like that, 2 power 16 as 64K. Okay, so now here the size of the ROM given is only 4K. So if it is 4K, it can be written as 2 power 12. Okay. So where there 12 represents the number of address lines. So that means here n is 12, it represents the number of address lines. So the address lines from A0 to A11 used. Okay. So but the address bus size of 8051 microcontroller is 16 bit. That is from A12 to A15 address lines. Okay. So these are the address lines which should not be used. Okay. So only these are the address lines that should be used, because based on the size of the memory, n value is equal to 12. Okay. So the remaining address lines and PSEN bar signal of 8051 microcontroller should be connected through OR gate to CS and RD signal of external ROM. And so when A12 to A15 are low, only external ROM will be selected. So that is why we are going to make in the memory mapping table the address lines from A12 to A15 as 0. Why? Because the address lines from A12 to A15 are not used. Only the address lines from A0 to A11 will be used, because the size of the memory is 4 KB. And so this is the address decoding table for memory mapping. So the size of the given RAM is 4K by 8. So here the value of N we got is 12. So that is why we will use only the address lines from A0 to A11. Okay. So the remaining address lines from A12 to A15 are not used. They will be connected through OR gate. So in order to select this ROM, we have to make all these bits as 0. So that is why here this is called the starting address and this is called the ending address. So here the starting address will be starting with all zeros, whereas the ending address will be ending with all ones. So here from A12 to A15 they will be 0. So the value here what you got is 000H, and here what we got is 0. So the value is here 0, and if it is 1, the value is F, and here the value is F, and here also the value is F. Okay. So based on this we are going to calculate the starting address and ending address. So here we have to draw the interfacing diagram. So the given size of ROM is 4K by 8. You have to interface that to 8051 microcontroller. So here port 0, it is of 8 bit. So using port 0 signals, we have to demultiplex the address and data lines. So by using this latch, we are going to demultiplex this D0 to D7 and A0 to A7 address lines. Okay. So whereas this ALE is used for demultiplexing, and here we have port 2, its size is also of 8 bit. So using port 2, the higher order address lines will be selected. So here since we are using only the address lines from A0 to A11, so anyway A0 to A7 address lines are used here. The remaining address lines from A8 to A11 will be connected through port 2. Whereas here, the remaining address lines from A12 to A15 are not used. So that is why they will be interfaced by using this OR gate, and they should be connected through CS bar and RD bar signal of this ROM. Okay. So ROM means read-only memory. So only reading is possible. That is why we will not connect this WR bar signal to anywhere in 8051 microcontroller. So this is how we have to interface a 4K by 8 ROM to 8051 microcontroller. And so next, that is what about ROM interfacing. And next case is here external RAM, which is called data memory interfacing. Now, so here we are going to consider RAM based on the given size. And so RAM means here random access memory. It means both reading and writing is possible. So we will have here port 3 signal. Port 3 is of 8 bit. They act as simple IO pins, and the same pins can also be used to perform different operations. Okay. So two pins related to a timer, two pins related to interrupt, one pin related to serial two pins related to serial communication, that is TXD and RXD, two pins related to interrupts. So similarly, two pins are related to read and write. So port 3, that two signals, read and write signals, will be used to perform the reading and writing operation for RAM. That means microcontroller can read the information from RAM, microcontroller can write the information to the RAM. And the same here, port 1, it is the dedicated port, simple IO port it is. And port 0 is used for demultiplexing the multiplexed address and data lines. So here we have a multiplexed address and data lines AD0 to AD7 and the address lines from A8 to A15. So using this port 0 and this ALE latch, we are going to demultiplex this address and data lines as D0 to D7 and A0 to A7. But here the address bus size in 8051 microcontroller is 16 bit. That is why the remaining address lines from A8 to A15 will be connected to through port 2. Why? Because port 2 pin diagram we have to recall here. So if we consider port 2, it is acting as a simple IO port. Okay. And it is also handling another signals that is called address lines. So here A8 to A15 address lines will be coming from this port 2. And RD bar, WR bar signal should be connected to WR bar and OE bar signal of this RAM. Okay. So port 0 is used as multiplexed address and data lines. Whereas here the external latch and ALE signal are used to provide the lower order address lines A0 to A7. And the higher order address lines from A8 to A15 will be connected to port 2. And RD and WR bar signals of 8051 selects the memory read and memory write operations that is performed between 8051 and RAM. So same as the previous example, how we have seen to interface ROM to 8051 microcontroller. This is another example. We will learn how to interface this external RAM to 8051 microcontroller. So here, design a microcontroller system using 8051. Interface the external RAM of size 16K by 8. So here the size of the memory is given as 16K. Okay. So first what we have to do is, here the memory size is given, it is 16K. Whereas we have to write this 16K as 2 power n. So here in order to get this 16K, the value of n should be 14. So this 14 represents the number of address lines. Okay. So here the number of address lines 14 means we are going to use the address lines from A0 to A13. So these are the address lines which we are going to use. But the address bus size here is 16 bit. So that is why the remaining address lines from A14 to A15 are not used. Not used means they will be connected through OR gate. See. So A0 to A13 address lines are used. Whereas the remaining address lines A14 to A15, they will be connected through OR gate to the chip select pin of external RAM. And when A14 and A15 bits are low, the external data memory will be selected. Now, so we will see how to do the memory mapping and how to interface. So here the size of the memory RAM is given as 16K. So in order to represent 16K, so previously the value of N here, what we got is 14. So that is why here N value is 14. So A0 to A13 address lines will be used. So this is up to A13. We have to use that address lines. Whereas the remaining address lines A14 and A15 are not used. They will be kept as zeros in order to select this RAM. Okay. So here we have to calculate the starting address and ending address of this RAM. So here the starting address will be all zeros and the ending address will be all ones. So here this is a 00, and by using these 4 bits we have to convert that into hexadecimal. You will get the starting address 0000H. And here this is the first 4 bits 0011 means it is 3, and remaining all are ones, the value will be F. Okay. So that is why here we will get 3FFFH as the ending address. Now here this is the interfacing diagram. By using this port 0, we are going to connect this higher multiplexed address and data lines. So by using this ALE and latch, we are going to demultiplex the address and data lines. So we will get A0 to A7 here and D0 to D7 here. And port 2 pins are used for used as simple IO port as well as the simple address lines. So only the number of address lines N is 14. So A0 to A13 address lines will be used. So here we got A0 to A7 and the remaining address lines A8 to A13. Whereas the remaining address lines 2.6 and 2.7, that is A14 and A15, these are the address lines that are connected to these two pins of port 2. They will be connected through CS bar pin of RAM through OR gate. Okay. And so here these two pins of port 3 signals are used for connecting read and write signals of this RAM. So this is how we have to interface external memory to 8051 microcontroller. Either it may be RAM or ROM. Now we will see how to interface IO devices to 8051 microcontroller. So here the IO devices we have considered, one is ADC, another one is DAC. Okay. So here ADC stands for analog to digital converter and DAC stands for digital to analog converter. So this DAC, it is going to convert the digital input signal into analog output signal. Here the digital input signal will be represented with the help of binary value in terms of zeros and ones. Whereas ADC, if you take, this is analog to digital converter, which converts analog signal into digital signal. So first we will see how to interface this DAC to 8051 microcontroller. So here DAC means digital to analog converter. Input will be the digital data and output will be the analog signal. So it converts digital data to analog output, so that output may be in terms of current or voltage. So basically there are two methods to convert digital data to analog. That is, one is binary weighted, another one is R2R ladder network. But out of these two techniques, most widely used technique for digital to analog conversion is R2R ladder network. And so this is the IC DAC0800. It is the IC which is designed based on this R2R ladder network for converting digital to analog. So here the digital inputs will be are converted into current output, and by connecting one resistor at the output side, that is I out, we are going to convert that particular current output into voltage output, because if the output is in terms of current, it is not possible to measure. That is why it should be converted into voltage by connecting a simple resistor at the output side. So digital to analog converters are required when the digital code must be converted to the analog signal. And this is the circuit which is saying how to interface DAC, that is 0800 to 8051 microcontroller. So here DAC means digital to analog conversion. So then digital input will be there, which will be in the form of binary. So all these are the digital inputs, and this is the analog output which will be taken at I out. So all these digital inputs will be connected to the port 2 of 8051 microcontroller. So here all this digital data will be converted into analog output, and it will be considered as the current output I out. But if the output is in terms of current, it is not possible to measure. That is why it will be converted into V out. So I out will be converted into V out here with the help of the resistor that is connected at the output. So here we have op amp. So this is the main circuit, which is output circuit, which is going to convert the current output into voltage output. So this is how we have to interface DAC to 8051 microcontroller. So as we have seen in the previous circuit, it consists of 8 digital input lines and 1 analog output signal. So the number of data bits will be decided by the resolution of ADC, and the output pin IOUT will be connected to the converted into current to voltage conversion. So for example, if the 8 input lines are there, that is D0 to D7, so maximum it will be within the range 00, 00, 00, 00 to the maximum 1. So within this range, we can have the digital input combination. So the range of D to A converter will be in the range 0 to plus 5 volts. So for the input 0000, the output of digital converter will be 0 volts. If all the inputs are of another combination, that means if you see the first data bit is 1, whereas the remaining bits are zeros. If this is the data from D0 to D7, the output voltage will be plus 2.5 volts. And if all the inputs are 1s, D0 to D7, all the bits are 1s, it says it is the maximum output voltage. So we will get plus 5 volts here. And another interfacing, another IO device here we are going to learn is about ADC. So ADC represents here analog to digital converter. So this analog to digital converter is input device to the microcontroller. It sends the initializing signal to the ADC to start digital data conversion process. So generally, if you take, this is 8051 microcontroller. So it will be taking digital data as the input. After performing the operations, it is also going to produce digital data as the output. But here, from the IO devices, from the input device or output device, if you consider, so the input device can give the analog signal, whereas the output device also takes the analog signal only. So in order to give the input to 8051 microcontroller, here we should have one analog to digital converter. Okay, and in order to take this output as the analog signal, at the output we should have one digital to analog converter. That is why this ADC is considered as the input device and this DAC is considered as the output device. Okay, and so here now, so mainly this analog to digital conversion process will be operating based on the two signals, which is called start of the conversion signal and end of the conversion signal. Okay, so when the start of the conversion signal is enabled, it should be set to a specific duration. So when SOC signal is enabled, the process will be started. That means converting analog to digital will be started. So the process of analog to digital conversion is a slow process. That is why the microcontroller has to wait for the digital data till the complete conversion has been completed. So after the conversion is over, the ADC is going to send one signal, which is called a EOC signal. So here EOC represents end of conversion. So when this signal is received from this ADC, we have to, microprocessor controller has to understand that the conversion is over and the result is ready at the output buffer of ADC. So this conversion from analog to digital will be carried out mainly based on these two signals, which is called start of conversion and end of conversion. And so these two tasks will issue the SC pulse to ADC. Reading SC pulse means start of conversion, and EOC signal from ADC, that is end of conversion. And reading the digital output of ADC are carried out by the CPU by using 8255 IO ports. And so now we will see how to interface this ADC to 8051 microcontroller. So this is what here Here, so we have this 8051 microcontroller and this is ADC. So here it is ADC. Okay, so the IC number is here 0808. So analog to digital conversion. So here all these are the 8 analog inputs. And after converting that into digital by ADC, we are going to get the digital outputs in terms of zeros and ones, that is D0 to D7. So how these particular inputs will be selected means it is based on the 3 control signals, which is called A, B and C. So if these 3 signals are 000, the analog signal from IN0 pin will be selected. So similarly, if it is 001, so the input from this IN1 will be selected and that will be converted into this particular digital output. So when this input is selected, this start of conversion signal will be enabled. After converting that particular input totally into digital output, then this EOC signal will be enabled. So these are the signals that are connected to this port 1. And here, this is the OE signal. And these are the 3 control signals which will be connected to another pins of port 1. And here, how this analog to digital conversion process will happen means, all these are the steps it is going to follow. So here are the following steps. So first, it will select the analog signal based on the provided bits like ABC address. So in the diagram we have seen ABC are the control signals that is going to select any one of the input. So totally it is having 8 inputs. So if this ABC combination is 000, IN0 input will be selected. That means the analog signal coming from this input will be selected and converted into digital output. So if this ABC is 001, the signal coming through IN1 will be selected, analog signal. And if it is 010, the input coming through IN2 signal will be selected. So similarly, if it is 011, IN3 analog input will be selected. 100, 101, 110, 111. So if this is the combination of A, B and C, so IN4 will be selected. Here for this combination 101, IN5 is selected. For 110, IN6 and 111, IN7. Okay. So based on this ABC signals, particular analog input will be selected. So total number of analog inputs for this ADC 0808 will be 8. So any one of the input will be selected at a time. And so we have to enable this ALE pin. Okay, so then only the address will be latched. And after enabling this ALE pin, we have to see that the start of conversion SE signal should be activated. So if this SE signal, that is start of conversion signal, is activated, then it is going to initiate the conversion. So this SOC signal will be enabled until the complete analog signal is converted into digital. So here, after converting the entire signal into digital, the EOC signal will be enabled. So EOC represents here end of conversion. So when this EOC signal is enabled from this ADC, it represents that the entire analog signal has been converted into digital and the conversion is completed. And next, the OE signal should be activated in order to read the data output of ADC chip. And so the pulse of OE pin will bring the data out of the chip. So this is how we have to interface memory and IO devices to 8051 microcontroller. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.